Just get it ready.
Yeah.
Oh, oh
no! Hello, friends. Welcome back to the vlog.
Yesterday, there was sun and there was rain. Beauty in the mundane. And as the light startled our eyes, we let go of disguise.
It is 2021, which is actually incredibly scary and awesome to say. It is a new year, which means all the new things that everyone wants to do in their life. I think that resolutions are really helpful and useful, but I feel as if you can resolve to be better at any time if you really set your mind to it. But there's nothing like a new year to really just take a hold and take advantage of that feeling that everybody is exhibiting, like, it's a new year, we're starting fresh, to do just that, start fresh. So anyway, this past new year I did a super low-key couples trip with my fiance Luke and a couple that we're friends with, Trey and Catherine, and we went to Delray Beach, Florida. It was absolutely beautiful. We did so many activities. We are both foodie couples, so we loved going out to eat and then going to the beach and staying really active, going on walks. I even went on a few runs, which is kind of unheard of for vacation, but I love vacation that lets me still be active. Anyway, we visited a bunch of really good restaurants and we had the most amazing food experience. I felt like doo-doo when I got back because I was eating such rich foods all the time. We ate out every single meal, probably except for one. So it was a really great trip and I might dive into a little bit more of it later. But I am back home and I have not been home since December 18th, so well over 10 days. And it was kind of foreign coming back into my apartment. For a second when I entered, I was like, ooh, where am I? But I have taken advantage of being back of just incorporating my 2021 goals into my life, and I just started from the get-go. I've put together my 2021 objectives and key results. I actually heard that from one of my favorite podcasts, What We Said. One of the hosts, Chelsea, she described 2021 resolutions as objectives, which are qualitative, and key results, which are quantitative. One you can measure, what is more of a overall objective for your life. I'm gonna dive into my 2021 objectives first. My number one objective that I want to do throughout the whole entire year is incorporate love and intentions into everything that I do. That means a variety of things. I'm 100% positive it's going to evolve as the year goes on. But I really want to open up and have better communication with everyone in my life, friends, family, my fiance, and with myself and how I speak to myself and motivate myself. And from that, I really want to work hard this year to be the absolute best partner I can be for Luke and be the best fiance and soon enough be the best wife that I could be. And I know that that is just it is an ongoing process. My number two objective, which can kind of be put into the key results category as well, is to have a better relationship with nutrition and from that with food. This is a trigger moment. This is going to be about food. I do not want to come off as some sort of expert. If you don't feel comfortable listening about other people's struggles with food, please just skip ahead. I'm going to put the timestamp up here. So I used to count my macros back in college and I have a pretty decent understanding on food. I am not a coach in any means, but I understand the basics of what and how to eat in a healthy way. But what I struggle with is whenever I go out of town or I go out to eat with friends is how to still enjoy foods that I normally wouldn't enjoy in my daily routine without completely blowing it out and derailing my goals, just because I feel like I won't enjoy the moment if I don't order everything on the menu. I definitely am starting to just incorporate that into my life. I'm not making some huge deal of meal prepping every Sunday and Wednesday, trying new recipes that I know I might not like. Right now, I'm cooking a bunch of foods that I have been cooking for a while, and I know that I like the meals that I make. I am experimenting a little bit, but I'm mainly sticking to the basics, and then I'll venture out once I have that solidified. But I definitely just want to get more into nutrition and read more about it and learn as much as I can about it, and then slowly incorporate it into my everyday routine. One thing I've learned is with diet, and I don't go on diets, I just look at diet more holistically, like how can I incorporate this into my everyday life? I need to ease into things for me to actually integrate them into my daily schedule. So if it's like making a new recipe, I have to ease into it and not blow it out of the park, because then I just will pass right over it after a few weeks. My next objective is to stay positive and have the mindset of how is this an opportunity for me to grow, rather than the mindset of why is this happening to me. I have noticed that whenever I literally physically stop myself from being too scattered or freaking out when a situation arises, and grounding myself for a second and saying, all right, let's get back into that positivity mindset, it helps so much, especially at work or whenever I am traveling or anything of the like. Things are going to happen to you whether you like them or not, whether you're positive or negative. Things are going to be thrown your way in life, and really the only thing that you can control, and this is just kind of like beating a dead horse because everyone says this, but the only thing that you can control is your mindset. And I think that is just so powerful to know that you can't control your external circumstances, but for the most part, you can control how you react to them. And then finally, I really want to take the beginning of this year and incorporate this into the rest of my life to notice and appreciate the small things. The small things like going on a date with your significant other, or reading a really good book, or waking up in the morning and realizing that you just got out of a really comfy bed and you're in your favorite pajamas and you get to go and make coffee. Things that you tend to overlook, but then when something goes abrupt in your life, or when there's a really big sudden change, those are the moments that you miss the absolute most. So I definitely want to just learn how to appreciate those moments way more and just notice whenever I'm in those moments, but also not try so hard to appreciate the moment that I ruin it. Those are my key objectives. And then my 2021 key results that I will achieve this year. My number one, work smarter and not harder. Actually, this is such a coincidence because when I wrote this list down, it was before I listened to my absolute favorite vlogger's 2021 goals. And I think it was her 2021 goals podcast or YouTube video, but she mentioned that she wants to work harder, not smarter. No. She wants to work smarter, not harder. And I was like, oh, 20, no wonder why I like you so much. But anyway, that's Michelle Reed. I'll put it up here, but she is amazing. And I really enjoy watching her content. But I truly believe that you don't have to work longer hours to be more productive. Some projects do require more time, but not all. And I have a problem where I procrastinate and I just mumble jumble my priority list up because I want to do something that's a little bit easier first and not the harder tasks. And there's all these things that I want to tweak, and I just have to come to terms with, just because I have the time to work overtime doesn't mean I absolutely need to get my list done. And I think that just working harder in the allotted hours that I give myself for a project will result in me being able to get off earlier and be able to not feel so rushed through some of my projects. And I also want to be more proactive and not procrastinate on the things that stress me out, because I'm gonna have to do them anyway. Another thing, I need less time on this phone. I do not want to be on my phone all the time. I have the worst habit of picking up my phone and scrolling through social media when I wake up in the morning, And the past 2 days since I've gotten home, I have not done that, and I have felt so much better and less stressed when I get up and I do my morning routine. And it has been quite the challenge, let me tell you, because I just really want to just pick it up and go doot, 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 right through it, but I can't do that. I'm actually going to get one of those alarm clocks with the little sun thing that wakes you up and put my phone in the kitchen to charge overnight. And from that, I want to read more. I'm actually reading a few books right now. One of them is actually this, the My Creative Space. It's kind of like a coffee table book, but it's very good. And I love the pictures. I am a picture book kind of gal. Like, how could you not be? I'm reading through this right now. This is my pre-bed read. In the mornings, I read my devotional and I read a book of the Bible. Right now, I'm working through Ecclesiastes. So from there, I'm also reading a novel. It's a nonfiction. It's, in a previous video, I've said this, but I'm obsessed with geisha books right now. Don't know why, but they're so good. I'm reading one by, Mineko Iwasaki, and it is amazing. It is Geisha Alive, but I'm gonna put it here and link it below. Really good book. And I'll also link my morning devotional, and, if I can find where Luke got my Bible, I will too. It's a custom one. It says my name. We're going to have to change my last name and get another one, but it's fine. Another thing I want to do is I want to keep incorporating the cleanliness routine I have now and also add on little tasks to them every day and rotate it throughout my week, whether that be vacuum at the end of the day, sweep, wash my sheets, clean the tub. Usually I do all of those things in one swoop, and I want to start integrating them little by little into my weeks so I don't have to do a huge clean day every other week. Two of my last ones, but they're definitely one of my favorites, is to take care of myself. What I mean by that is skincare, sleep, health, wellness, the relationships with people I have in my life, just taking care of myself. The few things that spring to mind initially are to have time to relax. I definitely always feel like I can be working whenever I'm not working and my projects are complete, and that is just not the mindset that I should have. Whenever it's time to relax and it's the weekend or after hours and I have everything done, I should not find another work-based project to do. And that doesn't mean like my 9-to-5 kind of work, but like overworking when I edit my vlogs, spending way too much time on it and not spending time just vegging out on the couch reading or watching a show. I definitely want to take more time to relax and have R&R and actually appreciate that time instead of trying to rush through it, because it does make a world of difference and it really does make me more productive. I also want to incorporate a better skincare routine, meaning like my body skin and my face skin. I have started using the Neutrogena body oil because my skin was really dry because of the winter here, and it has made such a huge difference. I definitely recommend. I'll link it below. I've been using it for a few weeks now and I absolutely love it. And then I also want to get into a beauty routine. This is a hot take because a lot of people are straying away from the makeup. They're like, natural, no makeup, blah, blah, blah. I do too much of the no makeup. Honestly, it's kind of like you need to have a healthy relationship with makeup. It's kind of like weird to say that. But as a girl, or even guys if you want to wear makeup, I feel like if you feel the need to use makeup as a part of your identity, that's where it gets a little tricky. But I absolutely love, I'm starting to integrate a daily makeup routine whenever I know I'm gonna be like on Zoom calls or going to see people or filming, just doing a very simple 10-minute makeup routine, and it makes me feel so good. There's something about just looking in the mirror and being like, I like that. Someone just knocked at my door. Let's go see what it is. It was Prime. I went to the grocery store and I forgot several things there, like dishwashing packets and stuff. So I had to order some. But to wrap it up, my budget. I need to make a budget. I have been winging it through life until this year. And I really want to get good at budgeting my money, and I want to have a very healthy relationship with my money and the income that I have and what I have to spend on and such. So those are my 2021 goals. I am so excited to just start integrating them. They are already things that I have began doing. And if you set goals that are just like way too exorbitantly high, it's gonna be so intimidating for you to just do them. I personally really like setting goals for myself that I know I can attain. And from there, I just build upon them and set new ones. But some people are different and they need to set really big goals and work up to them. So I hope you enjoyed. I hope you have a great 2021. If you have any questions or if you want to learn a little bit more about how I'm incorporating these goals, let me know. I would absolutely love to share with you. Anyway, we had a really good time in Delray and it was just so good to just have some time to like walk on the beach with Luke and I. And we got to see some really interesting characters and there are also beautiful cars down south. I mean, I'm pretty sure I saw like 75 Maserati moms skirting around the corner going to happy hour and didn't even touch the brakes once. I almost got run over by one, but you know what? You live and you learn. Absolutely love going somewhere and just like living there for a few days and not having to go and like blow it out of the park or do any huge touristy things. I think touristy things are pretty fun, but not if it's my whole entire trip. I like to just kind of do what the locals do, and especially because I used to live in the area, it was just really nice to go back and visit some of my favorite spots, especially with Luke there with me, because he's never seen my hometown where I was raised. Anyway, I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day. Whatever time of the day you're seeing this, I hope that you have a restful evening or a very productive day, or you just take some time to R&R. I'll talk to you later. Bye, friends.